Okay, last week, do you still remember the quiz we had on dummy subject, right? And there were two English sentences. He is easy to please and he is easy to be pleased, right? So there were two corresponding forms. I just want to make the correction. Last time I said, well, there might be just one. Actually, there are two, right? You can say, it's easy to please him. Or you can say, it's easy for him to be pleased. For him to be pleased. Okay, so there are two. That's okay. I just want to make that announcement. So let's go back to the homework for this week. I mean, last week. Explain the stative verbs. Why the stative verbs cannot be used with progressive. Why? Why these stative verbs cannot be used in progressive? 你们怎么回答的？没有答案。你们应该已经交作业了吗？ Do you want to know the answer? 'Cause the form of ing 永远回到形意搭配的原则。The answer is always in the communicative purpose and the mapping between form and meaning, right? So what does ing indicate? Ing means it's in the middle of happening. It's ongoing, right? Whatever can be ongoing must be dynamic. Okay, dynamic. But these are not dynamic verbs. There's no activity to be ongoing. But how can the following expressions be okay? So you have, she is having a baby, she's having a good time. The president is seeing the delegation. I'm seeing my family doctor. He's being obnoxious. Right? The same verb. Have, see, be is used with ing. How can this be? How can this be possible? The answer? Exactly, because the meaning is different. Okay, the meaning is different. So whenever you see ing, it has to be a dynamic meaning. It's an active sense. 可以吗？只要看到 ing, 它就是动态的语义，动感的，一定要这样。The meaning has been changed. So what's the meaning of she's having a baby? 不是她去抢一个来哦。Okay, 不是他去买一个来啊。So what does that mean? She's having a baby. Not just pregnant. Pregnant 也不是 having a baby 啊 right? Having pregnant 不是动态的嘛。She giving birth. In the process of giving birth. 所以 she is in labor. 这样了解吗？ She's in labor. Hey, 生产很痛苦的 okay? 要用力的。She's having a good time. Are we having a good time here? Are you having a good time in the class? Good. Okay, I hope. I hope. 怎样？这样很好啊。Okay. Make me happy, right? So we are having a good time. What does have mean here? We are having a good time. 诶，翻译还是，诶，我们有一个很好的时间嘛， right? But it's not have in the sense of ownership, right?This have means enjoy. And enjoy is a very interesting verb that we don't have an equivalent in Chinese. We'll see that, okay? Enjoy, enjoy doing something. So having a good time, okay? The president is seeing the delegation now. What is the president doing? He's seeing the delegation. What are you going to do tomorrow morning? I'm seeing the chair first thing tomorrow. What does that mean?Seeing, meeting, yes. Meeting someone or visiting someone. I'm seeing someone tomorrow. Meeting or visiting. So the meaning has to be changed in order to have ing. Okay? Next one. I'm seeing my family doctor tomorrow. Right? I'm visiting him. Okay? What does that mean? He is being obnoxious. He's being ridiculous. Don't be ridiculous. We say that, right? And he's being, you are being ridiculous. What does that mean? 上次我们才说过 be 动词是状态连结动词，记不记得？状态连结。If you have an activity, 如果有一个活动，你就用动词了嘛， right? 如果有一个动作，是不是这样？听懂了没？没有动作的时候怎么办？你还是得要有一个动词啊。So you choose be 动词， right? 所以我们叫它状态连结。所以还记得我们上次讲 He is tall， 英文的 he is tall， 你怎么翻译？不是他是高， right?也不是他高，你们一定要很清楚这个最简单的东西 ，right? He's tall 不是他是高，也不是他高，翻译成中文的时候是什么？他很高。那上个礼拜我讲过很，也是一个标记，对不对？标记什么？中文里面我们用很来标记什么？标记什么？什么叫很？哎，你知道，其实中文没那么难，哎，中文其实是最有意思的这种。形意标记非常清楚的语言，我加了一个很，它就有一个句式的语义，有一个 constructional meaning。所以你知道这个很的意思呢？我不只是说他很高，他很有钱，他很漂亮，他很英俊，我还可以说他很陈水扁，他很蔡依林。你们这个年代的年轻人很草莓。你们发现我后面还可以加名词？哎哎，这个 is it fine? Is it fine? 像什么？要笑就大声一点嘛 ，OK， 当然可以这样讲了。他很陈水扁，我很马英九，有没有 ？OK， 你们有没有这样用？哎，余光中说什么？天空很怎样？希腊不就这样吗？啊、哦，不是余光中，不是余光中，每次都说错，是郑愁予还是谁？是余光中吗？哎，我好像被纠正过。哎 ，Anyway 哈，天空很希腊，好不好？哎，这个设计很中国，有没有听过？所以它不是只是接形容词，所以很不是形容词的 marker， right？ 很在标记什么？你们不要笑啊，这是中文最重要的东西。以后你怎么教中文啊？你的外国朋友问你，哎，为什么你可以说他很蔡依林，他很周杰伦？有一个道理嘛，就是很在标记一个东西，以至于你可以这样用。这个就叫 constructional meaning， 有一个 construction， 那个 construction 就是很加 something。很加 X， 了解吗？那这个很在干嘛？很表达什么嘛？
后面是形容词。
不是后面是形容词，我已经跟你说后面可能是名词啊。
我是转换成形容词。
Exactly， 很的意思是很是什么？很是在讲一个程度嘛，是不是 ？Right？ 一旦有了很，你就发现你其实是在。表达程度，了解吗？就这么简单。所以很后面不管出现什么，它都是在表达一种程度的属性或属性的程度，有没有？高矮是不是程度？漂亮是不是程度？所有的形容词都是一种程度。所谓程度就是它是一个 scale， 它是一个 continuum， 它是一个 gradation， 了解吗？有不同的程度的，有不同的 points on the same scale， 可以吗？所以中文是用很来标记，是一种程度的修饰。那什么东西可以有程度？只有属性类的嘛，形容词性的。所以即使我说他很马英九，那个马英九也转换为一种形容词，一种修饰的属性，了解吗？好像没有什么感动哎，自己的语言哎，自己的语言哎，哦，好棒哦，对不对？为什么我这样讲？谢谢配合演出。哎，不要小看这件事情哦，你可不可以把很放在动作动词前面？你可以说我很打他，我很踢他，了解吗？你可不可以这样说？你可以这样说吗？当然不行嘛，哎，直觉一点好不好？Can you say that in Chinese? Can you say 我很打他，我很踢他 ？Do you understand what I'm talking? Yeah, 很 can never be used with an action verb, right? 你们发现这就是 exactly 中文的标记。所以我要讲的是 the simple point I want to make is there's always a difference between dynamic verb and stative verb. Okay? In all languages, we treat them differently. Even in Chinese, for any stative predication, degree modification, you use 很, right? But 很 is not allowed with action verbs.Because it's an action, it's not a degree. 这样了解了哈，程度才有所谓的 degree 可言。那中文我上次讲过，我们的英文的 be 动词翻译成中文就是加形容词或是名词嘛。比方我是老师，哎，这时候我就用是了。I am a teacher, you are students. 你们是学生，那这时候的是就出现了。所以中文的是到底是什么？它不是英文的 be 动词。虽然有一部分的语义跟 be 动词是 overlap 的 ，right？ 可是中文的是在表达什么？中文的是在表达什么？让你们回去想想看啊 ，think about it。好，所以 he is being obnoxious 的这个 be 要怎么翻译？你不要故作。可爱，你不要 behave that way, okay? You shouldn't act as, 这样了解吗？所以这里的 being 已经变成一个动作性的 behave or act, right? 最后 ，we can say I like to see movies or I went to see a movie last night, right? Do you like to see movies? I went to see a movie, but can we say I'm seeing a movie? 不行，来，你不能这样讲，那你要怎么讲？What can you say then? If you want to emphasize ongoing, purposely ongoing, 你要说 I'm watching a movie. I'm watching a movie. 那这一章第二章里面，你们有没有读到 watch, see, look 有什么不一样？啊，还没读到的赶快回去读。好，这就是作业的部分。我们继续进行第二章。We'll go on with chapter two.同样的事件可以有不同的解读。同样的，你看到一只猫追着一只狗跑。How do you interpret this event? The way you interpret this event determines the verb you choose. So the cat is chasing. Chasing 的关系是什么？追赶的，是一个及物的关系 ，right? 有始作俑者，有受害者的关系。But if you take it as a more playful event, then you might say, well, the cat is running after the dog. 我要你们特别注意啊，这两个词有什么不一样 ?Chasing 跟 running after. Chasing 跟 running after 有什么不一样？所以过去你们老师会说哦，这两个词是同义，千万不要再想讲这种话啊！没有两个词是同义的。There must be a semantic difference. Now, what is the difference? 如果你用 running after, 你是不及物的观念。The cat is running, right? The cat is running. He's running. 然后呢，你用一个介系词带出什么空间上面的先后关系而已。He's running after the dog. But basically.不及物动词没有强烈的操控关系，两者只是一前一后的奔跑关系，只是空间上面。我讲这个的重点就是不同的形式，它就是在表达不同的语义 ，right？ 那它的语义就是这个，了解了哈。所以你选择不同的动词，你就是在传达不同的意义。上个礼拜天我在台北市立图书馆演讲 ，I gave a talk at Taipei City Library。在新生不是建国南路上，有大概200多位听众，然后其中有一位，我在讲完之后，他就问我，他说：“老师，有很多文法书告诉我们 ，OK 这些道理，他说这是逻辑，但是呢，我了解了之后，我发现我自己在用的时候，我还是不会用。”我就跟他说 ：“This is exactly the purpose of the book or the purpose of the class。”这个课的名称叫做什么？英语语法的沟通功能。大 当你知道了这个形式背后的意义之后，你才能够用嘛。那你有什么语义，你就怎么用。你有什么语义，你就选择什么样的形式。Whatever you want to say, there's a form associated to it. So what kind of form you need to use is determined by what kind of things you want to say, right? Meaning determines form. Now, once you know the communicative purpose, the communicative function behind every form, you should be able to use the form, right? To convey the appropriate meaning.所以这边讲的就是当你 when you write, which verb you need to choose? Well, you need to know what form is associated with what meaning. And that's the whole purpose of this book, okay? Next topic is about 补语 As I said, verbs depict, describe events, activities, states. And every eventhas certain participants. So in order to convey the meaning completely, we need to add certain things, right? This is called complements. Without the complements, the meaning is not sufficient, right? The meaning is not adequate. So what kind of 补充成分 we need? What kind of 补语 we need?补语 or complement can be an adjective, a noun, a verb, or a clause. So let's start with adjectival complement, 形容词补语 She may grow. Okay, if you say she may grow, that's one sense, right? 她可能长大 She may grow. Everyone will grow, right? But adding taller, you complement the meaning with an adjective.所以补语的意思就是补充说明 Complement. What does that mean? Complement. We complement each other. Okay? She may grow taller. I made him. You made him what? Okay? You have to tell me. I made him happy. I found him interested in Chinese. But there are certain adjectives not suitable for this kind of use. For example, you cannot say, I found him Chinese. Why not?Why can't you say that? I can say I found him angry. I found him interested in English. Right? But you cannot say I found him Chinese. I found him British. You can say I found him divorced. Or I found him married. Right? But why not Chinese? English.It can work.
for example, I can say, I found him so British, or I can say, I found him so American.
Okay, I didn't have so. I found him Chinese. I know. You can imagine a situation where this still can fit. For example, you always thought this person is American. And one day you say, you know what? I found him Chinese. I found him to be Chinese.The point is, whenever you use after this find, it has to be some kind of a change. Okay? It's a change of state. Something new, something arise, just noticed. Something you just noticed. So it actually implies, 形容词表示一种属性的变化。Change of state, 表达受词所经历的改变 So it's a kind of change that you noticed. Taller, okay, made him happy. I found him interested. I found him, this Chinese is a permanent state. What I want to say is all these states are instantaneous states.But Chinese is a permanent state. You are born Chinese, and that will never change.
Professor, I think okay? In this sentence, you can appropriate it to behavior. Yeah. Not really where you're from, but you act like a person who is from China.
Okay. Exactly. I found him to be Chinese in his behavior, right? That's what you mean. But here, I want to use Chinese as an ethnic background. Ethnicity. That's not allowed. As I said, the point is, whatever you want to use it, whatever you use in this pattern, the adjective has to be what we call a stage-level adjective. It's not a permanent state. That's the point. It cannot be permanent state. That's why you can use it when you mean behaving like a Chinese. Okay? Behavior is changeable. So the point is, this is some kind of a stative change, or what I should say, an instantaneous state, not permanent. Changeable state, let's make it more clear. Changeable state, okay? It's changeable state. So behaving like Chinese is changeable. But being a Chinese is not changeable. That's your ethnic background. That's your ethnic identity, okay? All right. So this is adjective. What about noun? When do you need a noun? Well, the most basic one is an object, right? So when you have a transitive verb, you need to have an object. And also, as I said, 出现在be动词后面, if you have a be verb, then sometimes you have a nominal predicate. I am a student. I am a teacher. The book is taken to be a bestseller. Okay? So, noun, nominal predicate occurring after be. Another occasion you will see a nominal complement is what we call 同位修饰. What does that mean? He was elected to be the president. So whenever you have nominal predicate, you can always say to be. Okay? We consider him a hero. We consider him to be a hero. Same thing. 同位的意思 means you have a noun. And this president, this noun, is equal to the previous noun in terms of grammatical status. They are at the same level, status. Their status is the same. So that's what 同位修饰语 means. Okay? He was elected the president. The president 是修饰谁? 修饰 he. So he is the president. We consider him a hero. Him. He is a hero. 这个叫同位修饰。可以吗? 下面。 所以我们来比较一下哈，同位修饰语跟受词不一样。 看起来都是名词, but they are different. 同位修饰语, a nominal predicate, 表身份关系, there's no concrete reference. So he is a teacher. Teacher represents a kind of status, a kind of job. It's not a specific entity that you are referring to, this teacher versus that teacher. It's not referential. It's non-referring, 没有具体的指涉. Okay, non-referring. But when you use a noun as an object, it's mostly, it's referential. So mom cut her finger. The finger, a specific finger. There is a reference for the finger. I am a student versus Tom broke the vase. The vase has a specific reference. 懂不懂我在讲什么? Referring. Okay? 这是一个语义上很重要的东西，这也是跟可数不可数有关的。 When we talk about count noun or uncount noun, 什么叫可数? When something is countable, that means you can individuate. Do you understand what I mean? 可以个体化。书是可数的，为什么？ Because we talk about each individual or book. An individual is a referent, a specific referent. Okay? So whenever you can individuate something, it is countable. But here, teacher. It's like an abstract type. It's like a type. Okay, it's a type of thing, type of job, type of status. It's not a specific referent that you are talking to. It's not a concrete object. 可以吗，亲爱的？了解了哈。下面，动词补语，这是我们上次讲过的。We talked about this last time. 当动词的语义牵涉到另一个动作 ，When a verb involves another action, when a verb involves another event, then you have to use 动词补语。He wants to do something. He plans to do something. He hopes to do something. Right? It requires another event. Then you have to use a 动词补语 And 动词补语有三种方式。那我们上次已经讲过形式背后的语义，还记得吗？原形动词有原形动词的语义，不定词有不定词的语义，进行式有进行式的语义，还记不记得？还记不记得啦？好，原形是什么？复习一下，原形是什么？失去时态，所以就失去什么？自主性，所以就完全依附于另一个动词。不定词呢 ？To， 还记得 to 表达什么？空间的位移，在时间上就是下一个目标，下面要做的事，所以在时间上的目的。进行式呢？有了 ing 就表示什么 ongoing 已经发生了，记不记得？所以它其实是一个名词性的东西。记得我们上次讲为什么动名词加 ing? Why a gerund, a nominalization would require ing? Because adding ing, you are changing a verb, an action into a noun. It's like an object, like thing, like 懂不懂我在讲什么？像个东西一样存在着 ，OK，All right。那下面呢，我们要看一些有意思的例句哈。These are some sentences I saw before. When I went back, it was 1994. When I came back to 新竹 ，OK， after I got my PhD degree, I came back to 新竹。And at that time, there was a campaign, okay, for mayorship. 我看到某一个市长，不讲是谁了哈。One of the mayors put a sign, a big sign everywhere. It says, 让新竹最好。Fine, right? 中文很好。But the English was, let 新竹 the best. It's all over the place.Everywhere, let 新竹 the best. Anything wrong with it? Do you see anything wrong? 有没有？有，哪里？少了 B. Let 新竹 be the best. 这就是所谓的动词补语。Let, 你要搞清楚为什么 let 后面要加一个动词。Let 的语义是如此的吗 ？Let 是什么意思？是让你做什么事情 ？I let you do something. I let you go. I let you drop the class. I let you at the class. OK， 所以 let 是让 allow you permit you to do something. So you have to have a verb. 这样可以哈。下面，感谢你愿意来。我常常看到这种句子哦。This is a common mistake a lot of students make.Thank you for willing to come. 有没有看过这种句子？感谢你愿意来。Thank you for willing to come. Anything wrong with this? 中文直接翻译嘛。This is called Chinese style English. 中式英文 right? 感谢你愿意来。What's wrong? For 的后面，上次为什么我们有一个 homework? 我让你们看。介系词后面加 ving， 为什么？那你看到哦，这也是 ving 啊。可是 willing 是什么词 ？willing 是形容词。I'm willing to do something. OK， I'm willing to do something. 因为 will 本来其实这是一个名词哈，加上 willing 变成形容词 willing。 所以你没有动词在这里，没有动词，你要讲清楚 thank you for 后面一定要接一个名词嘛， OK， 所以你 either 用动名词 being willing to come， 或者你直接用名词，那 willing 的名词是什么？ thank you for your willingness， yeah， OK， thank you for your willingness to come。 这些常犯的问题都在于不可或缺的动词补语。 You have to have a verb， 可以吗？下面 forget， forget 后面可以接什么？ OK， forget 的动词补语，你忘了，你忘了写作业，什么意思？ forget 的事情到底做了没？如果用 to be 是表什么？未来的想望， ing 永远是表示什么？进行的事情。所以 I forgot to tell him 是表示 I forgot 我有一个目的，我要做的事情是什么？这样了解哈。所以 to tell him is the purpose or the goal。 所以忘了要告诉他，但是如果我说 I forgot telling him the good news 呢？你有没有看到？哎，一边吃一边听着啊，这就是我一再要强调的。英文有两个不同的形式 ，right? You see two different forms here. Okay? And what does that mean? You have two different forms. You have two different meanings. That's it. 这就叫做形意搭配的原则。固定的形式搭配固定的语义， so 固定的形式 to be to tell is mapped with a fixed meaning is always conveying a goal. Okay. When you have ving, it's always conveying the ongoing stage of a verb. So 如果已经 ongoing 了，表示它完成存在，所以我忘了，其实我已经告诉他了。你可以用 I forgot telling him or I forgot having told him, right? 你可以用完成式来表达之前，还记得我们在前面讲过完成式表达之前完成的。好
Professor,
Yes, please.
Can you go back to the one about Sinju?
Sure.
Is it necessarily wrong that let Sinju the best? Is it grammatically wrong?
It's grammatically wrong.
Where I see it is, for example, I'll let you leave your stuff at my place.
Leave. You have to have leave.
But you can say a permission, for example.
The point is, you have to say, exactly, you have to, I let you leave your luggage here. You have to have a verb. That's the point. Okay? So you have to say, you let Xinju do something. That's the point. Okay? Yes, please.
普通的实义动词像 make 跟 have， 那用 make 的话，那如果后面那个受词是一个被动的动作的话，是直接加 PP。
很好。
为什么 that 要加 be 加的？
很好，谢谢你提醒我这个。上一次有一个问题我还没有回答，我们今天来回答一下。来，我们写下来。Make him leave， 被动。如果这句话改成被动 ，OK， I made him leave， 改成被动是什么 ？He was 什么 ？Made 后面是什么 ？He was made 什么 ？To leave。非常好的问题 ，This is an excellent question。So, if you see two different forms, there must be two different meanings. So, at least, you should know there's a difference between active and passive expression. 主动和被动其实在表达两种不同的语义，这个我们都知道。但它不是只是主被动之分而已。注意听哈，我打他， Okay, 我可以说 I was punching him. 不要躲啦，不很痛啦。I was punching him at 2 o'clock. I was deliberately punching him. 我这在描述的其实是一个即时的事件。Okay, it's a time anchored at a specific, it's an event anchored at a specific time. 所以我在描述的其实是一个事件，动态的事件。I punched him. 但是被动呢？我在描述的是我的这个动作造成的结果，懂吗？ He was punched. 当我说 he was punched 的时候，不再是动作，不再是事件，而是结果。你们了解我在讲什么吗？ OK， 他被杀了三刀，是结果。He was hit 是结果，所以意思就是主动的这个动作，我打打打打打踢踢踢踢踢，然后最后造成一个结果，这个结果是什么 ？He was hit。也就是说，我们从来没有学过这个，是我自己以前在台湾学英文也从来没有这个概念，一直到我自己读了语言学，我才知道哦，原来被动还有一个语义上的讲究，就是所谓的状态化。A passive sentence is stativized. A passive sentence actually describes a resultative state instead of a process, an activity, an action. Okay? This is very important. 好，所以回来了。为什么前面我可以说 made him leave? 我刚刚讲过，这是一个事件嘛。Okay? 这是一个时空相连的事件。So I made you and you leave.可是变成被动的时候呢，我是在讲那个 result 已经没有时间上的连结，所以我必须用 to 来表达一样的意思目的。 OK， 所以被动有点像什么你知道吗？有点像 I am here， 我已经有动词啦，了解吗？ I am here 干什么？ To teach。 被动的它的形式意义其实有点像这样子 I'm here to teach， 跟刚刚那个 I made him leave 那个 make 跟 leave 之间的连结已经没有了，因为那是在 make 的那个当下， make 的这个动作中， make 的这个事件中才有那个连结关系，才有那个实意关系，这样可以接受吗？所以重点就在于被动是一个状态。 OK， 好，非常好的问题。我记得上次还有一个人问我问题，我上次还没回答，就是 it is 的问题。上一次我们说 it 是一个虚主词，那下课就有同学来问我说 it is that 的句型呢？我写在这边哈。OK， 比方我问 who did it， 你说 it is John who did it。Right? It is in this class that I learned about English grammar. 有没有这样子？所以 it is that 没有错， it 仍然是一种虚主词的角色。为什么？因为它没有实质的语义嘛。然后它又是一个代名词，它又站在主词的位置上。You can consider it as a dummy subject, fine. But the point is, it 不是只有 it itself. It 是在一个标记的 pattern 中， OK， it is that 整个是一个标记，这个我们在语法上叫 clef focus， 这就是一个特别 a very special form for you to focus on something， 这个叫 clef focus， 所以 it is John 是你的 focus， 所以语法提供了一个 device 让你可以借由形式很明显的标记你的焦点是什么。你也可以说、oh, John did it as an assertion. It's a normal way of saying it, right? 这个我们叫 unmarked. 语言中一般的常用的 你在沟通上面没有什么特别的 extra effort 的，这个我们叫 unmarked 形式。John did it, fine. 但是有一个 marked 形式，这就是一个 marked 形式。It is John who did it.It is John that did it. OK? 可以吗？所以这是一个很特别的标记。那它不是只有 it， it 是跟着后面的东西一起走，就是 that。OK？ 所以回到我们刚刚讲的这个重点，我为什么会特别强调这个？就是因为我记得在国中 ，I remember when I was in middle school， I memorized one rule， saying that continue。还记得 continue 这个字吗？后面可以接不定词，也可以接什么动名词？你们有背过？我记得考试的时候，我们就哦看到不定词就勾，对不对？看到动名词就选。但是后来我就发现，哎，那我自己在用 continue 的时候 ，when I need to use the verb continue， right？ What do I do with it？ Should I put to be or ving after continue？ It seems to me that I don't know when to use to be。When to use V-I-N-G. Did you have this problem? Huh? 你有没有这个问题? Do you know when to use continue to do something or continue doing something? How do you decide? Yes?
Continue to do something is like you,you have a task and a lot of things you got to do and you continue to do something other but it's still in the task.But、continue doing something is like you're still doing this thing.、
Mm-hmm.
Continue doing it.
Okay, so what is the crucial point there? The crucial difference? What? 没有停 No stop. Is that right?、
the doing one is what to do.
Okay. Like, you might be right. But think in terms of what I said.In this class, to be has a special communicative purpose, right? What is it? To means what? 目标，目标，目标，在这里是目标吗？我了解好，不定词的目标。所以 to always conveys 一个目标 objective, right? 我 continue 意思就是说我 continue 的目标 I continue in order to, right?I continue in order to do something. 我有没有做别的事情其实不是重点，是 I continue in order to do something. 是我的目标。OK? 但是什么叫 continue doing? 我 communicate 的是什么？这个 doing 的事情已经，就像我讲的，已经是 ongoing 了嘛。所以为什么 So, by inference, 一个很自然的，你的一个结论就是你没有终止。Okay, I continue doing something, 因为这件事已经 ongoing, 所以继续做，它一直在 ongoing, 中间没有 gap, okay? 没有 gap, 没有时间的中断。可是为什么 continue to do something 可能有时间的中断，这就是你刚刚讲的，也许我做了其他的事情，我再回来做这件事情。为什么是这样？这不是必然，了解哈？因为 continue 的目标，了解吗？那我说过，目标跟你实际的动作之间可以有一个什么时间上的 lapse 还记不记得 I plan to do something 我可以是 plan to do something tomorrow 吗了解吗 So I continue to do something 只是标记了我的目标那我实际做了没不一定 Exactly 不一定 OK 像 start 也是这样子吗这样了解哈所以我们等一下就会看到这些动词那今天要在 forget 的地方特别强调的就是如果你的 forget 已经加了 ing 就表示其实是非常不同的语义在这里面语义非常不一样所以 你说 continue to do something 你要翻译成继续要做什么事情了解吗可是 continue doing 是继续做已经做的事那同样的在这边我是忘了要告诉他我故意把要红起来看到没我的目标是要告诉他这件事情可是如果我已经告诉他了呢我又忘了是我忘了其实我已经告诉他了这件事两个语义非常不一样的 OK 下面那这个是我们刚刚已经讲过的我就不再多讲了哈 make 或是 had 后面都可以接完全操控的实义动词补语以原形出现失去了描述事件的能力依附于主要动词表示完全且立即见效的操控这就是语义你用这个形式要表达的就是这个语义，你只是要把那个语义搞清楚。下面 是否立即的因果关系呢？我们可以来比较这几个动词啊 ，cause、make、order。时间上可以分割，所以 I caused him to go 中间可以隔了很久。Make 时间上无法分割，完全同时同地的操控 I made him go。Order 时间上可以分割，意图支配，可是是支配谁？支配另外一个人，所以主观片面的希望对方人保有自主权。I order him to go， 他走了没？他有选择权，这样可以吗？所以这是因果关系 cause， 这是什么？支配关系。那 make 呢？既有因果，也有支配，而且是完全的支配，这样可不可以？所以这个部分我们先告一个段落，我们休息一下再继续。OK。Next, we are going to talk about 子句补语 causal complement. Causal complement. Some verbs involve another event, a complete, independent, separate event. For example, I think, I say. The content of your thinking, the content of your saying can be a totally different event in a different time, in a different place.So I think that it will be raining tomorrow. I can think about tomorrow. It will be raining tomorrow. I can think about the past. I think that he came back last week. You see, you have two separate events. Oops, where am I? Okay, I have two separate events. The events of thinking. The events...of raining, the events of coming back. How do I know these are two separate events? Because they have different tense markings. Okay, they have different tense markings. Now, besides verbs, sometimes we use a clause to complement a noun. For example, the fact. What is the fact? What is the content of the fact?I can use a causal complement to detail the content of the fact, right? So the fact that global warming is affecting many parts of the world has been addressed by many scientists. 你们看到 that 子句通常用在这两个地方，一个是作为动词的补语，另外一个是作为名词的修饰语。这些都是子句补语，有没有问题？ Now, 提到这里，就有人要问，什么时候 that 可以省略？ Sometimes, 我可以省略 that， 比方我说 I think you are good, right? 我也可以说 I think that you are really good. 请问什么时候我一定要有 that？ 什么时候 that 可以省略？When can that be omitted? 看看这两句话。I think global warming is affecting the world. 有没有问题？有没有问题？有没有 that? 没有。I think, 你 think 的后面是一个子句。Global warming is affecting the world. Okay? 理解上有没有问题？理解上有没有问题？可是下面这句呢？ The fact, global warming is affecting the world.很多人问这个问题 ，that 什么时候可以省略？如果你去看补习班的参考书，你会看的一个头两个大。You always feel confused when you look at those 补习班的 cram school 的 textbooks. Okay, there's only one simple reason to decide whether that can be omitted or not, and that is 是否会影响理解。Again, 什么东西都回到沟通来看。我用 that 的目的是要标记。标记什么？标记 that 后面是一个子句。是一个完整 a separate 的子句。哎，无伤理解的时候呢，置于动词之后。OK, 所以无伤理解的时候，置于动词之后可以省略。可是通常呢， 在名词后面不能省略，为什么？因为你有两个名词并排 ，the fact global warming， 你们看到 the fact 跟 global warming 之间有没有关系啊？你如果把 that 拿掉了以后，就会造成语义不清，所以两个名词并排语义不清，所以通常置于名词之后的是不可省略。为什么至于动词之后可以省略？因为 think 的语义已经告诉你它后面要接一个子句。The meaning of think already indicates that you should expect a clause, a separate event. 这样了解吗？ But I have nothing to expect after the fact. 有没有道理？有没有道理啦？有没有道理？ Does that make sense? Okay.下面 suggest 的用法，以前有没有背过？ Have you memorized this rule? Suggest 后面可以接原形，也可以接什么 should， 有没有？也可以接一个子句嘛。 So there are actually three different uses of suggest. 我们先看一下它的用法。 I suggest that you leave right away， 原形。 I suggest that you should leave， and I suggest that Mary should have leftRight? 这三个都是 acceptable 的 expressions。 回到我们的形意搭配的原则，不同的形就是不同的意， right? 好，那请问这三个不同的形有什么不同的意？ What are the three different meanings in the three different forms? 第一个，回到原形，还记得原形的意思是什么？时间上的立即性，时空上的连结性，还记得？所以 I suggest you leave 的意思就是 我建议你立刻离开，通常就会跟 right away 合用。 I suggest you leave， no time to lose， leave right now， 这个叫原形的意义，时间上的立即性，这样了解好。所以原形表达立即性， should 表达什么？ should 只是一种判断，以后我们会谈情态助动词， should 只是一个判断，就是你应该离开，这样对你比较好，但这只是我的一个什么建议，你自己想想看，这样了解哈。所以加了 should 就表示建议而已， OK。 所以在下面这个呢， I suggested that Mary should have left， 你这个时候如果再当成建议翻译很奇怪。 How do you translate this sentence？ 你不能说我建议玛丽可能已经离开了， Can you say that？No, in Chinese, it's not acceptable when you use 建议, right? You have to change the verb to 我推测. So you see, this suggest is totally different in meaning from these two uses. 这样了解哈？可以吗？为什么？为什么在这里它要翻译成 Why do we translate suggest here as 猜测？为什么？外文系的同学，请问上面这两句话跟下面这句话有什么不同？这两句话的不同是所有情态助动词都有的。 The distinction between these two meanings between 建议versus 推测 can apply to all modal auxiliaries. Think about must. Think about the use of must. Must 可以有几种用法？ How can you use must? How many ways you can use must? 想想看。 You must study hard, right?You must study hard. You must pay attention. You must keep awake. Okay? 这样了解啊？这个 must 是什么？我对你的责任的判断，你应该，你必须。可是另外一个 must 呢？刚刚是一定要， right? 一定要用功，一定要努力。另外一个是 it must be him. 今天你看到房间乱乱的，你说 it must be him， 今天你接到一封书 一封信没有写名字，你说 It must be him， 什么意思？不再是一定要，而是一定是他。这是表示对可能性真实性的推测。这就是每一个情态助动词的两种不同语义。一个表达喜好，听着，喜好。You should do it. You must do it. You have to do it. You ought to do it. 这是我的喜好的判断。可是另外一种呢，是真假的判断。It must be him. 你们了解我在讲什么吗？一个是真假的判断，一个是喜好的判断。So one sense is about my preference, my intention. The other, it must be him.Is my judgment about truth, about probability, about possibility. 那这两个呢，就是所有情态助动词最重要的用法。那今天我们不是讲情态助动词，但是我在这边稍微提一下 ，OK？ 下面，接下来我们就要花一点时间，希望能够在三点以前结束，把动词的十大语义类型谈一谈。Remember, I said this again and again. The best way to learn a verb, about a verb is to learn the semantic type it belongs to. In other words, the meaning of the verb comes in types. There are categories of actions. There are categories of semantic types. 还记得吗？学动词要学它的语义类型，而不是学个别的。You don't learn verbs individually. You learn which semantic category it belongs to. Once it belongs to a specific category, then you know how it is used. I'll show you what I mean. For example, 状态连接。如果今天没有动作 involved, there's no activity, 活动 involved, then it must be...be 动词 she's nice. 那跟 be 动词类似的还有 she appears pretty happy. Again, 没有动作 involved, 没有活动 there's no activity involved. She becomes angry, no activity involved. 所以这些动词为什么是同一类？他们都是在描述状态。Okay? She's a vegetarian. She turned into a vegetarian. 这些都没有活动，没有动。如果有动作，那你就用动词了嘛，就是没有动作，没有活动 involved， 这样了解哈。所以这些都叫做状态连接动词。那连接什么？连接状态。状态有什么呢？状态可能是一种属性，形容词的属性，可能是一种身份 ，OK， a vegetarian， 可能是一种关系 ，I'm your father， you are my teacher， OK， 这样可以哈。这是第一类，所以所有的没有活动。动作 involved 的都是 这一类。第二类，及物不及物，这个我们已经讲过很多次，我不想再强调了哈。及物不及物是活动的，了解吗？所以你先要分它是状态还是活动。那如果是活动呢，它又分为静态的活动跟动态的活动 ，jump、beat 这些是动态的活动，也有静态的活动啊 ，like。Envy, no, 看到没 ？OK， 实义动词，这是第三种。我们刚刚已经讲过了，完全的操控，所以只要它后面用原形动词的，都有这种完全操控的语义。所以 again， 你看到形义的配搭，这种 make 类型的 verbs， 除了 make 以外，还有 have， 有没有？还有 let。他们都有完全操控。那刚刚下课有一个同学来问我一个很好的问题，他说你可以说 I made something blue, I made something broken, right? 我可以直接加过去分词 I made something broken, right? 可是用 let 就不行，你不能说 I let something broken, 你只能说 I let something to be broken, right? 我说这个道理很简单，因为 make 就不是 let, let 就不是 make。Let 的语义是什么？永远都是 permit someone to do something， 所以 let 后面一定要有动词。可是 make 呢，后面可以接形容词 ，I made something blue， 表达一种结果。因为 make 的结果可以就是一个形容词 ，OK， make something broken。可是 let 后面一定要有一个动作。那在类型之内还有这些个别的词义，这就是词汇的意义了 ，OK。下面。第四种叫做想望喜好类，我叫做 modality verbs。注意看哦，我为什么叫 modality verbs？ 情态助动词也是 modality 的意思。modality 的意思就是表达你的一种 mood，OK？、Okay? 你的一种 mood， 你的一种想望，你渴望的事情，你的 desire， 你的 intention， 这个就叫 modality。那所有的想望喜好，你想的，你希望的，你喜欢的，你爱好的。都是使用不定词，因为它表达未来的心愿，这样了解吗？未来的心愿 ，OK。时间上呢有一个区隔，所以 I plan, I want, I desire, I prefer to marry him, OK。再反过来看，只要你看到有 to 的、to be 的，了解吗？只要你看到这个形式，你就可以反推它的语义一定是表示什么？未来的心愿，未来的目标。我们把心愿后面加上一个目标，这样好不好 ？OK。再来，第五类是支配，支配类啊。什么叫支配？对你自己你不用支配，支配通常是支配什么？You manipulate 什么 others， 所以我用 manipulation 这个动词哦 ，manipulative。You want to manipulate someone else to do something， right？ 就这么简单。所有的 manipulate verbs 都是期望他人做某事，期望他人。那既然是 someone else， then you have to have an object. Order him to do something to take a break. I made him take a break.这是刚刚的实义动词，来做一个对照 ，OK， 可以吗？一定要用 order，OK？、Okay? I order him to take a break， but he didn't。如果你说 I made him take a break， 你就不能说 but he didn't， 这样了解吗？了解这个意思哈？有什么问题 ？I order you to take a break， but you didn't。你不能说 I made him。Take a break, but he didn't. 因为这边已经有完全的操控，所以语义上的冲突很简单的表现在动词和它后面的补语形式上面，可以吗？这叫做操控类的动词哈，操控类的动词，支配类的动词。第六组，感官知觉动词。什么叫感官知觉？感官有一个很特别的地方，其实很多动词的表现，你要回到它的语义去想，这就是语义类型的意义。什么叫感官啊？你可不可以操控你的感官？啊？你说我很想专心，可是呢，我就是睡着了，又有人要吃酸梅了。OK， 生怕我觉得我们不能完全的去控制我们的五官。你想听的，一定听得见吗？你不想听的一定就听不见吗？这就是五官啊。五官是什么？有一种是可以自主的，比方我说你好好的看，你是可以有某种程度操控你的眼睛去看，了解吗？这个叫做可以自主的。所以我可以说请你 look carefully， listen carefully， 这是你可以控制的。可是我可不可以说 see hear？这两个词表达的比较是非自主的。你说哦 ，I saw something 是表示你的目光 spot something， not under your control， 你就是自然看到了嘛、哦。我不想看，我就是看到了。噪音很多，你不想听，可是你就是听到了，因为你的五官会自动的接收。这个就叫做非自主的，这个就叫非自主的，是 see 和 hear。那他们表现出来的不同在哪里？记得我们刚刚讲说，所有动态的、自主的，你都可以加 ing， right？ So you can say, I'm looking at someone. I'm looking at a beautiful girl. 但你不能说 I'm seeing a beautiful girl. 因为 see 所表达的是一种非自主的五官感官。So you can say, look, there's a butterfly there. Can you see it? Okay? 你只能这样子用，你不能说反过来 see, there's a butterfly. Can you look it at it? Okay? 语义就不通了。Where is it? I don't see it. 你不能说 I don't look at it. OK? 了解吗？这两个语义。那中文有没有这个不同？我们每次想英文就觉得英文好烦啊。事实上你的中文一模一样，所有语言都要分的。因为它就是的确有这两种类型。你可以认真的去看，有操控性的看。有一种就是你没有办法操控，你自然会看到的。你的感官。因为感官就是有这种现象。你的语言自然就要表达这个不同。请问中文怎么表达 see 跟 look 的不同？又回到中文了。交大越来越多外籍生啊，以后人家一定会问你这些问题的。我说，请你注意听，注意什么？看。可是什么叫做 I saw a bird in the tree? 啊？瞥见，你会这样说吗？我瞥见一只鸟，哇，好文言哦，你在写诗。可以啦，我同意，只是一个 special 的 register, right? 不是常常的口语吗？你口语怎么说？我就是我看到啊，就这么简单。你说我看到那个到，你知道那个到的意思是什么吗？到的意思就表示到，就这么简单，表示你的确到达了，你看，而且你看到了，意思就是这样。所以其实你知道 see 的意思是 I received something, 是你接收了，你接收到这个五官传来的讯息。所以中文就是看到看见， OK, 就是 see 跟 hear。 下面感知的对象呢，它可以是名词片语， right? 你说我感知到 something, I heard something, I saw something, 没有问题。可是呢，感知现象却有三种表达的方式。第一个，你可以用原型 I heard them talking, I'm sorry, 原型哦， I heard them sing, I heard them talk, 有没有？你可以用原型。那 again, 回到原型的语义。你也可以用进行式 I heard them talking, I heard them singing, 进行式的语义。你还可以用子句，你可以说 I heard that they are singing。 诶，你这有没有写错啊？还是书里面写错了？ I heard that they were singing 才对。书里面是 are 还是 were? 你写错了，书里面是 were。 OK, 可以吗？这三个不同形式又有什么不同的语义？原形动词就是原形的语义，时空相连 ，OK, 时空同时。进行式强调的是什么 ？Ongoing, 共识的进行。That 子句呢 ？Separate 的 event, 所以这个事件本身是可以跟 heard separate 的。那以至于。See 其实发展出另外一个语义，人的眼睛看见可以表达脑袋理解，所以我说，哎，懂不懂？你说 Yes, I see, 有没有？看见眼睛的看可以经过一个转换，变成你的认知上的理解。OK, 所以很多时候你认知上的理解也变成。I saw that, 表示我理解，然后后面也可以接一个子句 I saw something, 这个完全可以跟感官无关，这样了解哈 OK。 使用子句表达事件呢，这就是我刚讲的，如果我把它变成一个不同的时间点呢， I heard yesterday that he left last week,用子句的时候，我就是可以表达不同的事件，所以我的时间可以是不一样的。我故意用两个不同的时间点。I heard yesterday, heard 的时间是 yesterday, 那他离开的时间是什么 ？Last week。可是这个用在进行式跟原型就不成立了。OK， 那个是共识进行。另外，刚刚讲的从视力到脑力 ，I see 到 I understand。So I see your point， 不是睁着眼睛看，是 I don't understand your point。那理解的知识不见得看得到。I see that you had a good point in your argument。这完全是在讲抽象的，了解哈，可以吗？好，第七种样貌呈现动词，我一直不知道怎么翻译这个，因为你们的国中课本把它这种叫做连缀动词，你们有没有听过？我一直是不懂它什么叫连缀动词，所以我想把它翻译的更语义上面 有意义和 meaningful 一点。So I chose 样貌呈现 because 这些动词的重点不是你做什么 ，OK？ The semantic focus of these verbs is not something you do or you don't do. The emphasis is something appear to you, look like, OK? Means something appear in front of you. 以刺激者为主体的呈现方式，描述外物的样貌，重点是外物的样貌 ，OK， 跟你这个人要做什么无关。所以 ，it looks pretty， it sounds funny， 这个 it 是外物，是这个刺激物 ，OK， 刺激物。It looks like a bird， it 是一个外物，它呈现出来的是 look like a bird。所以你可以看到那个真正 looking 的人不重要了，是外物的样貌，这样了解哈。那你怎么去形容外物的样貌，就是用这些 look like， sounds like， 所以我叫做样貌呈现动词。那你后面为什么要加一个，你看这里的 look 跟刚刚那个 look 是不一样，因为它的主词不是 I look at someone， 是 it looks like， 重点在于永远它的动词不是人，而是外界的刺激物 ，OK， 外物，这样可以哈。第八种，思考沟通动词，这组动词我们常常用，今天的作业也跟这个有关。思考和说话这两件事情是人类最基本的活动，你思考，然后你就说，所以你知道中文也是这样说，我想说，请问我想说是你想还是你说？我想说中文很容易，我想说英文很难，听得懂吗？我想说 Do you understand what I say? 我想说，为什么中文说我想说，这样了解吗？就表示想其实就是说，说就是想，懂不懂我在讲什么？ OK， 说话思考是同一类的，那后面用补语子句引述思考的内容或说话的内容， OK。那在引述的时候你有两个选择，一个你可以用间接引述，right？ 你可以说哥白尼 said claimed， 这里应该有一个这个哈 claimed what the earth is round。 那这个间接引述呢，你可以看到没，前面是一个事件，后面讲一个习惯事实，所以我有不同的时态。间接引述完了以后，我们还可以看直接引述， I didn't promise to promote youThe manager claimed. 这个放在引号里面表示原因重现，原因重现。You just repeat what he said. Exactly, I didn't promise you to. 是 manager 所说的。The author wrote. 你加了引号的都是直接引述。所以这两种表达思考沟通的内容，那基本上它都有一个 that， 表示后面的是一个完整的事件，独立的事件 ，separate 的事件，有自己的时态，有自己的人物，有自己的字地点。OK， 第九种给予，什么叫给予？什么叫给予？这些动词基本上就是在描述一个授予的事件。什么叫授予？我把这个东西给什么？给他。所以他的参与者 the participants in this kind of event transferring 一定牵涉到什么 something you transferred and someone who receives it, right? So recipient and the object 是必然的参与者，你就要有两个名词在后面，看到没？给予物和给予接受者，所以你有一个给予的人，然后你有给予物。I gave a letter. I gave a book to him. 接收者。那这个句这种动词有一个很特别的地方，就是它有两种表达形式互换的。I gave a letter to him. 你可以把它改成 I gave him a letter. 有没有看到？你可以把 recipient 放在前面。那请问，根据我们的原则，不同的形式有不同的语义，这两个形式有什么不同？ What is the difference between these two patterns? 你知道早期我们在学 Chomsky 的那一套，就是所谓的 transformational grammar， 你们有没有听过？这个叫做 dative movement， 你们有没有在那个 syntax morphology 里面学过？有没有学过？没有？有没有学？忘记了，很诚实，很好。这个叫 dative movement， 所谓 dative 就是这个 to 啊，哈 ，to him 被移到前面来 ，I gave him a letter。请问在语义上，你要选择用哪一个 pattern？ 我们这堂课真正是在教怎么用英文呢？我不是在教英文文法，我是在教你怎么用英文文法 ，right？ So 如果有两个 pattern， 你要怎么用？你写作的时候你要选择用哪一个 ？How do you decide？我来问 ，OK, let me give you a question and then you answer me. If my question is, what did you do to the book? What did you do to the book? How would you answer me? What did you do to the book?
I did nothing to
the book. You did, tell me, give me a sentence with give, OK? What did you do to the book? 你会选择 I gave it to John.还是 I gave John the book. Yeah, 你一定会说 I gave it to John, 有没有发现？ Why? 所以这两句话其实有一个很简单的不同，就在于谁是你的 topic? Who is the topic? Who is thematically more important? 如果我已经说了 What did you do to the book? 那 book 是什么？比较 topical, 是 given 的。你就会放在前面讲，了解吗 ？So, what did you do to the book? Oh, I gave it to John. 因为已知的先讲 ，OK? 那我说 ，what did you do to him? Oh, I gave him the book. 所以放在前面跟放在后面还是有 information packaging 的问题。Information packaging, OK? I make my communication.More understandable, easier to understand. 再问你们一个问题哈，校友，你帮我写下来。I spread the paint on the wall 跟 I spread the wall with paint. 你帮我写这两个句子，等一下我们再来讨论。所以我要跟你们说的一个好玩的东西是说，你看哈，形式本身有语义。你即使不是语言学家，你也应该要学会这个形式本身有语义。今天假设我给你一个 pattern， 我说主词哈，然后呢加一个动词，不，你自己来填，不管是什么动词啊，然后后面必须是 MP， 后面有两个 MP。If this is the pattern I give you and I ask you to fill in the blanks。Okay, what would you put there? 不管主词是谁，我后面有 MP MP， 你会放什么动词在那里？你有没有看到？这是一个形式，我没有任何词汇嘛 ，right? What kind of verb will put there? 我给他一本书，我 give right?用英文想，还会给什么？你还会放什么在这里 ？What else will you put here? Send, I send him a book. 还有呢？ I bought him a book. Good. 还有呢 ？I mail him a book, right? 可不可以？所有的这些动词，你会发现都有一个给予、收受的语义。Whatever you choose to put in the blank has to be a verb of transference. 可以吗？这样清楚了吗 ？OK。那请问如果这样子的 pattern 是授予的关系 She baked him a cake 什么语义 I baked him a cake 可不可以可不可以这样说可以那请问 bake 是授予 的动词吗我为什么可以这样说所以你知道为什么学词汇很难？是因为我们常常以为词汇是单独存在的。No, a verb doesn't exist by itself. It's combined with other elements in a sentence. And the meaning of other elements will also influence the meaning of the verb, right? So when you put bake in that sentence, she baked him a cake. It automatically acquires...A meaning of the construction. It acquires a meaning of this pattern. 什么叫 baking a cake? 也是有 transfer 的语义 right? 我 bake 给你一个 cake. 可是你在字典里头会查到这样的用法吗 ?bake 是什么词Bake 后面绝对不会接两个受词嘛，对不对？你通常是 bake a cake, bake cookies, right? 了解我在讲什么吗？那这时候你就会发现，所有的字 ，however large a dictionary is, you wouldn't be able to see sentences like this. 所以查字典不是没有用，而是有限。为什么？因为这里的语义是从整个句子的 pattern 来的，是从整个句子的形式的 form。Of the sentence has meanings too. 你们了解我在讲什么？不是只是词汇有意义 ，OK? The pattern itself 也有语义。I spread the paint on the wall, 跟 I spread the wall with paint. 如果你只是看语义，你会觉得哦，这两句话很像嘛 ？I spread the paint on the wall, 跟 I spread the wall with paint. 可是你再仔细想想，这两句话有一个很大的不一样。什么不一样？通常我们说放在动词后面的，放在动词后面的我们叫什么？今天我要给一个很重要的观念，放在动词后面的我们叫什么？直接受词 ，direct object。什么叫 direct object？ 就是 direct 被影响的 ，directly get affected。Under the direct influence, under the direct impact of the verb， 这样了解哈？这叫 direct object。所以这两句话，一个是 I spread the paint on the wall， 跟 I spread the wall with paint。请问谁受影响？如果我请你选选看哈，请问哪一个句子可以表达整个墙都被涂了？哪一个 ？First one or second one？ 整个墙都被涂了。整个墙都被影响了，你会用哪一个 ？I spread the paint on the wall。我强调的是 paint 被影响，这样了解吗？你们懂我在讲什么吗？就是 paint 是 the direct object， so paint is under the direct impact of my action。So spread paint on the wall， 可能我只是丢甩了几笔色彩在墙上而已，我可能就是刷了一笔，这样了解吗？可是当我说 I spread the wall with paint 的时候 ，the wall 受影响的程度是比较大的，这样了解吗？所以我可能整个墙都怎么样，都涂上了，可以体会得到吗？哪一个受影响的程度多，你就把它放在直接受词的位置 ，direct object。OK， 好，下面最后一类了，感谢享受，这就是我说 enjoy 这个动词 is very special。 可以感谢的事情必然存在，所以以 ing 表示，比方 enjoy 跟 appreciate。注意哈，中国人通常我们感谢的对象都是人嘛，比方谢谢你，对不对？谢谢你。可是英文的这个 enjoy 跟 appreciate， 听着哦，它的对象都是动作。enjoy 是 enjoy doing something， appreciate 是 appreciate something， 绝对不可以是 appreciate someone， OK？ 你是 thank someone， 可是你是 appreciate something， 注意这一点哈。感谢某事，这个叫做 enjoy appreciate， 为什么中文里面没有？就是因为我们觉得我们只对人有感谢，可是我们很少说感谢事情。什么叫感谢事情？我们没有这个概念。appreciate， 享受，享受是享受某一个东西，可是我们很少享受做什么事情。所以这是中国人的悲哀哦，因为我们做事都是只是责任而已。We don't know what enjoy doing things。感谢什么？感谢缘分让我们相遇，可以啊。缘分不是人啊，缘分是 something 啊。缘分是什么？ I appreciate the opportunity to meet you， 可不可以？ The opportunity of meeting you， OK， 缘分就是一种 opportunity， OK。 所以你可以说 I enjoy your company。 注意哈，为什么你要说 I would appreciate it if OK you respond to me as soon as possible。 I would appreciate your responseAt your earliest convenience， 有没有？你不能说 I appreciate you。我常常看到中国人这样用，即使是学了很多年英文的人也会这样用，那就是没搞清楚 appreciate 的对象是事情。所以永远记得，你背的时候你是要这样背的，你是 appreciate something， enjoy doing something。即使我没有 doing， 我的意思还是 doing。比方 I enjoy the coffee， OK， I enjoy the book。其实你只是把那个事件省略了。Enjoy coffee 是 enjoy drinking coffee， enjoy the book 是 enjoy reading the book。 你们了解我在讲什么哈？好， thank 呢？ thank 跟 apology 是对人的 apologize， OK， apologize 表达对人的感谢。所以 I thank you for something and I apologize， 怎么是 apology 呢？ I apologize to you， OK， I what？怎样？书里面就错了吗？
没有。
OK， 是 I apologize to you， 这样可以吗？那你会说为什么 apologize 要加 to？ 因为 apologize 是不及物的概念。为什么？我道歉，对象是你，这样了解吗？而不是我给予你。你们了解我在讲什么吗？ So, 所以你可以说 I apologize 就好了， right？ I apologize 对象才是 to you， 可是 thank 一定要有一个对象，你才能 thank。Thank you, OK。一个动词可能有多种用法。最后我要强调这一点。你知道我们过去常常背的是说，一个动词后面又可以接 v， 又可以接 ving， 又可以接什么，我们就这样背起来。那今天我要告诉你们的是，当它接不同的东西，它其实就是不同的动词。所谓不同动词是说属于不同的语义类型，这样可以吗？属于不同的语义类型。所以还记得我们一开始讲 want。Do you still remember the uses of want? Want 其实有三种不同的语义类型。I want something 是及物的概念。I want to do something 是什么？想望、渴望 do something。I want you to do something 是什么？支配。这样了解？你要从这个角度去看动词。Remember， 所以 remember 有几种用法，它就有几种语义。第一种用法 ，I remember his name， 及物的。那这个 name 就是什么 ？Remember 的受词。我也可以说什么 I remember his coming to visit me， again 它还是及物的，只是名词变成了动名词，因为它基本上都是名词。第二种，所以这两种其实是一类哈。第二种 I always remember to， again 我们刚刚说过 to do something 是什么？是目标，是目的，是心愿。所以 I remember to do something， 这是喜好想望类的语义。如果我用 that 子句呢， I remember that he moved to 新竹，就变成什么？思考沟通类的语义。 请问这样子学动词你觉得如何？跟你以前一个一个动词去背有没有差别？为什么要这样子？因为形式是有意义的，你不需要一个动词去背 remember 后面可以接什么接什么，而是要了解 remember 它的语义类型有几种， remember 它的动词类型有几种，可以吗？最后我们来看一下，这个就下课哈。 See, watch, look 有什么不同？我花很多篇幅谈是因为我在写书的过程中我还在教课，然后常常教一些课学生就会问我问题，这是一个学生问我的问题。老师，为什么我们要说听着啊， See a movie but watch TV， right? Right? 你可不可以说 I'm going to see a TV？所以这些道理不同在哪里？ Look 表示感官上主动的调整，我们刚刚已经讲过了。 Look 是 I'm looking at someone， 表示你的眼光停留在哪里，是你可以自主的调整的。 See 表示什么？目光不自觉的接收。所以 What do you see on the picture? I see a forest， 是指你接收到视觉接收，这叫 see， right？ Look 是你主动的去控制你的眼光，那 watch 呢是专注而投入的什么？观赏。这个所谓观赏是不但眼睛看，而且什么心思跟着欣赏，心思跟着注意，这个叫 watch 啊，目不转睛的叫 watch。 所以你说 watch him 有没有叫你小心，是你目不转睛，听到没有？ watch dog 有没有？是这种目不转睛，是专注而投入的观赏。 So what are you doing?I'm watching TV， 这个意思是什么？我目不转睛的在那边观赏。可是我可不可以说 I'm looking at the TV？ 我可以说 I'm looking at the TV。 What are you doing? I'm looking at the TV。 跟 I'm watching the TV 有没有不一样？了解吗？ Look at 你可以就是看着那个什么电视机的机身嘛。 You can look at the object, the set, right?而不是 watching a program， 这样了解哈。所以 watch 是有 program， TV program。 下面 see 呢， see 是表示自然的接收。 So I'm going to see a movie， 那你为什么用 see？ 你看电影的时候 supposedly 你当然也是目不转睛，可是不要忘记电影是一个很强烈的视觉效应，它不断的在刺激你。所以当我们说看电影的时候，我们强调的是我一直在接收这些视觉的讯息，所以我们用 see。 好，那我们怎么把这三个词放在一起看？目光的初接触 look， 专注的观察 watch， 视觉的接收 see。 所以 he looked at the menu， 你是不是 look at the menu？ 然后呢 and decided to watch a new program， and then in the program you saw the beauty of Taiwan。把它放在一个 meaningful 的 context 当中去学，可不可以？那在这边我还是要强调，语言是活的，因为人是活的。所以刚刚我们说，我如果要强调我很专注的在看电影，我还是可以用 I'm watching a movie， right？ I am looking at a TV。 那可不可以用 see 接 TV 呢？我也想到了一个情境是可以的。如果你们看到课本里面有一个例子，我就说，哎，你今天晚上要干嘛？你说，哦， I'm going to see a TV program， 还是有可能的，了解吗？什么叫 I'm going to see a TV program？ 你用 see 就是强调 see 的语义，就是哦，我可能想要看一看这个节目。所以你们了解我在讲什么吗？虽然语言有一些 convention。Watching TV versus seeing a movie， 这是一般 大部分的情况，可是你仍然在语义上是有自由度的，你就可以选择不同的形式。 What are you going to do? Oh, I'm going to see some TV program。 你这时候的 see 表达一个不太一样的语义，跟 watch 不太一样的，但是仍然是 understandable。 只要语义允许，语法就没问题。As long as you can say something, you can make sense of something, 你的语法就要跟着去配搭。OK? 今天讲的有没有问题？今天讲的动词有没有问题？我们的动词基本上告一段落，所以下个礼拜请大家回去看第三章。第三章。